Hello everyone! Today is part one of my bird pattern cane series. I'll be showing you guys how to make a simple but cute bird cane out of polymer clay. I also wanted to mention that this video was suggested by Painted Lady to create a polymer clay cane based off of a thrift store cup featured in my DIY Christmas gift video. And this is what it looks like. Whoever designed the pattern for this cup did a fantastic job. The pattern is super cute, even though the veneer is scratching off. I held onto the cup because it was just so pretty and bright. Unfortunately, there's no signature or anything for me to identify the artist, but if anyone recognizes the work, please leave a comment below so that we all know who created this lovely design. To start off, we're gonna first create the base for the bird wing. Take 3 grams of mint polymer clay log and squeeze it into an oval cane. Then board it with a thick layer of brown clay using thickness level 2 of your pasta machine. You'll need roughly 2 grams of brown clay. After that, reduce your cane to increase the length. Get it to about 6 centimeters. Then cut the cane into 6 equal pieces. Next, stack 4 of them side by side in a staircase arrangement. This will form the base for the larger wing on the bird. Do the same thing for the other 2 pieces for the smaller wing. Now let's finish wrapping up the bird wing. With a sheet of brown clay at thickness 0, make a slanted cut at the end. Then make a straight cut, which is a quick way to make a small right triangle. Stuff this into all 6 crevices of the wing base. Here's a closer angle, so hopefully you can see a bit more clearly what is going on. After filling up the crevices, take another layer of brown clay at thickness 0 and wrap this around the larger wing cane. I usually make a little mark with my fingernails to know where to cut off excess clay. Compress and decompress in order to squeeze out gaps of air. Lastly, do the same thing for the small wing. Wrap it with a thick brown layer of clay. About 5 grams of brown clay was used for both additional borders. Now that we're done with the wing, let's move on to the belly. Take a layer of yellow polymer clay at thickness 0 and wrap this around the larger wing. Compress and decompress to squeeze out air gaps while forming the desired wing shape. The tail will be added to the top right, the neck to the top left, and a more fuller belly along the underside. First, do the tail. Take a sheet of yellow clay, slice multiple rectangles, and stack them on top of one another. Then squeeze the top to form a triangular shape. Attach this to the body and gently work it in. Next, for the belly, take another sheet of yellow clay with a slanted edge and add this along the bottom. You can definitely customize how puffy of a bird you want it to be. I'm just adding a little more to accentuate the chest. After that, apply pressure around the sides to blend the layers together. While doing this, fine-tune the bird's body shape. Add curves where you want them to be, around the neck area and belly, and taper towards the tail. Now, you should have something that looks like this. Now we're going to create the bird beak. Take less than 0.25 grams of dark green polymer clay and roll this into a log. Pinch one end of the log to create a point so that it looks like a triangular cane. It's easier to do this on a glass or glazed tile, so that the small cane will stick to the surface. Set this beak onto the side. Small shapes like this are easy to overwork, so it's good to let it rest up for a couple of hours while you work on the other bird body parts. Next, create the eyes of the bird. Take a small amount of dark green, this is less than 1/4 of a gram, roll it into a log and keep rolling to gradually make it smaller. Set this down on some yellow clay at thickness level 3 and wrap this around the green log until there are about 2 surrounding layers. Now we're going to thicken the right side of the cane. Here I'm adding one layer at thickness level 4. Then I add on another layer on top of that one. This is just to offset any possible imbalance once we add the beak to the left. For the beak, start with a yellow log that's about 2 grams. Pinch across one side of the log. Then pinch another end across the log to create a U-shape. Create a curve in the gap with your thumb or index finger to leave enough space for the other eyeball log to fit inside. After that, attach it to the eyeball log as if it's a cap. Work those pieces into each other to blend the seams a bit. Pinch the end of the beak to sharpen it and make the shape more beak-like. Now we're going to create and attach the neck of the bird. Start with a square cane that's around 2 grams. Pinch across the edge of the square, then do the same thing for the adjacent edge. Work your thumb or index finger into the gap to create a curve. The bird's head will fit into the curve. Next, we're going to do the same thing to curve out the bottom for the body to fit into. Pinch one edge while pushing into the gap to curve it out with your index finger. I'm also using my thumb to pull the other edge outward. Lightly fit the body into the neck to see if you need to make any adjustments. If the neck is too big, gradually trim a bit off from the bottom or from the top until you get the right amount. It's pretty easy to pinch the corners again to curve it out. Widen the neck for a more natural bird look. After the neck is at the length and width you're happy with, fit the head and body into the curved gaps. Then compress and push to work the pieces into one another while refining the shape of the bird. Unless you want your bird to sport a nude beak, we're going to attach the colored beak we created in step 3. It's going to be attached to the mouth of the bird. This isn't required, but if the clay is firm enough, round out the bottom two edges of the triangle. Then, trim off the excess polymer clay from the bird mouth. Use a round clay tool or your fingernails to create a small curve where the beak will fit into. After that, take the beak and fit this into the mouth area. Push to work it into the bird's head. Make any fine-tuned adjustments. For display purposes, you can minimize the seams by taking some tracing paper and running a flat clay tool or your fingers along the seams. And here is your cute and simple polymer clay bird cane. Don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button if you haven't already, and I'll see you guys in the next video for the bird pattern cane series.